The latest generation of Apple 15-inch MacBook Pros use USB power delivery to charge the Macs. They come with a 87-watt USB power delivery charger. However, if you happen to lose yours or need another one, Best Buy offers an Insignia branded 90-watt USB power delivery charger with a tethered cable. To test the OCP and IV curves, we will go ahead and use the GRL C2 as well as the GRL PowerSuite Pro. What's nice about this setup is that you don't need any other external ELODs or power delivery controllers to do these tests. Next, let's go to the OCP and IV curves automated tests for both ports. And again, we can go ahead and read the PD source caps for the Apple 87-watt charger connected to port 1 and the Insignia 90-watt charger connected to port 2. On port 1, to run the full test, we simply need to press the play button, and a window will pop up. It'll ask for which current that we want to start searching for an OCP trigger. This current is typically the smallest max current value that's advertised in the PDOs, and we'll just leave that as the default value of 2.4 amps. So now the test automation is running, and you can see that the first 5-volt rail is negotiated to, and current started ramping up quickly to the 2.4 amp setting that we had just set, and then it slowly starts to then find the current level where the OCP trigger is hit. So we can see that it triggered around this level, and then after some OCP recovery, we can see that the second PDO voltage of 9 volts is negotiated to, and again after 2.4 amps we start searching for the current where an OCP trigger event is found. We'll wait for the trigger to be activated. You can see that it again after an OCP recovery, then the third PDO is negotiated to. In this case, it's 20 volts. And here it'll probably take a little bit longer, since you can see that the max current for the third PDO, the 20 volt rail, is 4.3 amps. So after about 2.4 amps, it's slowly, very small incremental steps, it searches again for that OCP trigger. You can see here we can actually set the current step sizes where we look for the OCP trigger. In this case, it's 0.025 amps, so it's taking a lot of steps to try to find that event. And here it's just here it just occurred. So after the results, we can after the test is done, we can take a look at the results, and we can find that the points where the OCP triggers are made, which current levels. And the first PDO, we can see that the 3.44 was the OCP trigger level, which was actually about 43% higher than the 2.4 amps, which was advertised. And for the 3 amps, and the 4.3 amps level for PDO 2 and 3, we can see that the OCP levels were about 18% and 10%. We can also see at the bottom here that here the IV curves, which is basically the relationship between voltage and current. We can see how much voltage drop is seen as the current increases. Now for port 2, which again is connected to the Insignia 90 watt charger, you can see that there's no 2.4 amps min, so we'll just go ahead and use default value of 3 amps, you'll first go ahead and select the 5 volt rail, and after 3 amps, you'll start searching for the OCP trigger. You can see that trigger is found. So one of the big differences with the Insignia 90 watt charger, you can see very clearly here, is that there is no OCP recovery. So this may not be such a good user experience. Perhaps it's a safety feature that was used to just make sure nothing is wrong, so the charger has completely shut down, and the only way to actually get the charger to recover and communicate again is by removing the Insignia charger from the AC outlet and plugging it back in. So because of this behavior for the Insignia 90 watt charger, we'll need to go ahead and actually individually select each of the PDOs to test for OCP. So after doing a reset on the charger, we can see that it finally recovers and again advertises the same 5 PDOs as before. So rather than selecting all, which we know can't be done, we will just select the second PDO for 9 volts 3 amps and again execute. Here we can see that the 9 volts was successfully negotiated to, and after 3 amps we'll again find the OCP condition, and after that condition is found, again we can see there's no recovery, so we'll need to stop the tests. Let's go ahead and run the fifth PDO, 20 volt rail, separately and see how that behaves. Here we'll go ahead and keep the 4.5 default current setting. We can see that the current increases very quickly to 4.5 amps, and we can actually see that over 5 watts is allowed by the charger. And in the results, we can see that the charger actually allowed the sink to pull 5.3 amps. What is surprising is that the 5.3 amps that trigger the overcurrent protection is more than the 5 amp limit defined by the USB specifications. By comparison, you can see that the OCP trigger levels on the Apple 87 watt charger is well within the USB 5 amp specifications and generally stays within a 10, 20, or roughly 40% increase over the max current of the PDO associated with it. So just be aware that while the Insignia 90 watt charger does allow you to charge the MacBook Pro 15 inch, the overcurrent protection behavior is totally different.